Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to talk about epimers. So before discussing about this topic, first of all let's know what exactly is the definition of epimer. So epimers can be defined as if the two monosaccharides differ in their configuration around a single specific carbon atoms. Okay, then these monosaccharides will be called as epimers, right? That means if we take two monosaccharides which are differing only differing by the configuration around only one carbon atom, okay, then they will be called as your epimers, right? So to understand this topic better, I have taken three examples here. I have taken D glucose, D mannose and your D galactose, right? So having said that, all the three molecules like your D glucose, D galactose and D mannose, all are monosaccharides and all are hexoses. That means they are having six carbon atoms and all are having the same molecular formula, that is C6H12O6, right? So to understand this topic better, I will first compare between your glucose, D glucose and your D mannose, and then in another example I will compare between your D glucose and your D galactose, right? So let's get started. So having said that, glucose is epimer to both your D mannose and your D galactose, right? So for your convenience, I have taken two examples. This is one example and this is another example. Okay, in first example we can see this is your D glucose molecule, this is your D glucose molecule, and this is your D mannose molecule, right? So you can see both are having the same formula, C6H12O6, C6H12O6. Both are having six carbon atoms in their structure, right? So if we compare between these two molecules, D glucose and D mannose, we will find that if we see the configuration around all the carbons of both your D glucose and D mannose, we will find that they are resembling almost similar, except that at carbon number 2, okay, at carbon number 2, this is carbon 1, this is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. In case of your D mannose, this is carbon number 1, this is carbon number 2, this is carbon number 3, 4, 5, 6. So when we compare between these two structures, D glucose and D mannose, we will find that both these structures, D glucose and D mannose, are resembling almost similar, but except at the configuration of carbon number 2, right? You can see in case of a D glucose, you can see that at carbon number 2, hydrogen atom is attached to carbon number 2 in its left side, but hydroxyl group OH group is attached to your second carbon towards the right side. But in case of your D mannose, you can see the second carbon is attached to your OH group, hydroxyl group, towards the left side, but the hydrogen atom is attached to its right side. Okay, so you can see that this is the difference. These two molecules, D glucose and D mannose, are differing only at the arrangement of different functional groups like hydrogen and OH group around the C2 carbon, carbon number 2, that means second carbon. Okay, so these two molecules are differing only at carbon number 2, only by arrangement of different functional groups like hydrogen and hydroxyl or hydroxide group around your second carbon. Okay, in case of your D glucose, second carbon is attached to hydrogen group towards left side and hydroxyl group towards right side. But in case of here, we can see in case of your D mannose, the hydroxyl group is attached towards left side and hydrogen group is attached towards its right side of the second carbon, right? So this is the difference. Okay, so this is the difference. Okay, this is the difference. That means the two molecules, D glucose and D mannose, are differing from each other only at carbon number 2. As the two monosaccharides are differing only at carbon second carbon, they are called as C2 epimers. So we can say let's take another example. In this case, we are relating between your D glucose and your D galactose. Okay, both, as we can see, both these you know monosaccharides are your hexoses because they are having six carbons in their structure, right? And both are having the same molecular formula, that is your C6H12O6, right? Glucose has also the same has the formula C6H12O6, and the same formula is also exhibited by your D galactose. Okay, if we compare the structure between your D glucose and D galactose, we will find that these two molecules are almost similar to each other, but they are differing only at carbon number 4. They are differing at only carbon number 4. That means you can see at carbon number 4, you know, hydrogen group is attached to its left side, but your hydroxide group or hydroxyl group is attached to its right side. But the fourth carbon, in case of your D galactose, you can see your hydroxyl group is attached to its left side, while the hydrogen group is attached to its right side. So they are differing from each other. Both these molecules, these two molecules, that means D glucose and D galactose, are differing from each other only at configuration or around your carbon number 4 carbon, that is fourth carbon. That means the fourth carbon, in case of your D glucose, is attached to your hydrogen to its left side, and your hydroxide group or your hydroxyl group to its right side. But in case of your D galactose, you can see the fourth carbon is attached to its hydroxyl group to its left side, unlike your D glucose, and your hydrogen group is attached to your right side, right? So both these molecules, that means these two molecules like your D glucose and D galactose, are differing only at the configuration of molecule only at your C4 carbon, right? That means fourth carbon, right? As these two molecules, D glucose and D galactose, are differing from each other by the configuration of different functional groups like hydrogen and hydroxyl group around fourth carbon only, then these two molecules are called as your C4 actinomers. Okay, as glucose and your D galactose are actually, you know, differing from each other only at carbon number 4, they are called as C4 actinomers. So we can say both D glucose and your D glucose and your D galactose are related to each other as C4 actinomers. We can say D glucose is C4 actinomer to your D galactose, and D galactose is C4 molecule C4 actinomers to your D glucose, right? So this is all about your actinomers.